So, I'll quickly start. So, we started SimpliCash way back in 2015, May of 2015. Yes, we are trying, I'll quickly get into the philosophy of what we are trying to do. From our tenant perspective, we are trying to find them or help them discover a place which is closer to their workplace, along with all services end to end. For an owner, we focus on giving them a regular rental income along with their house maintenance. So these are the two pronged things for tenants as well as for owners. So all of us have been through this at some point or the other, where we face all these pain points. I'm not going to read it one by one. You can just have a look at it. So these are the tenant focused pain points, like brokerage, or I have to manage my service, I have high initial cost. I'm coming to a new city, I face all of this. The way the current solution works is they have the friends get together, they'll share the cost, and then when somebody goes out, they'll try and find someone else. So all that hassles that tenant has to go through. Now as far as the owner side is concerned, these people, like, our owners are typically people who are not residing in India or in the city, right? These people have a lot of property and houses in the city, but they don't have a way to manage them. And so they currently go through a broker network, or they go through direct interaction managing everything. Right? So this is the pain point which SimpliCash is trying to solve for tenants as well as owners. Now, when I talk about the solution, so we are a tech-enabled platform where we are a discovery platform, plus we provide all the services. So well-maintained services, well-maintained places near to your workspaces solves the problem of tenant who wants to live in a clean environment in a decent place. And it helps and it gives that clarity to owners that, okay, my place is in a good hand, it'll be well-maintained. So from an owner perspective and from a tenant perspective, this is one of the most critical thing that we do. There's no brokerage involved, there's low initial setup cost, and there's fixed monthly rentals. You don't have to worry about if your friend is leaving the house or not. That's on us, we'll find a replacement for them. You just have to pay your fixed rental and live hassle-free. And then all the utilities and services management, and then we give a certainty of when you will leave, how much deposit you'll get back, because that's the biggest problem right now people face. Is somebody will charge 1 month, somebody will charge 2 month rent, you never know what happens. So that is a certainty that we give people, and they can live tension-free in our houses. Right hand side of the slide, you see an ecosystem that we have developed. That ecosystem tells you about, see, when I come into a new city, I need a good place to stay, I need food to eat, I need commute, right? And then probably I'll need my personal belongings that I'll get along with me. So all these things becomes a part of our ecosystem, and the power of this is that I only pay at the end of the month. I don't have to pay as I use. So it's like getting into Uber and getting out of a Uber, and your Paytm balance gets deducted automatically. So you take all these services, it provides you a small credit line, which is very important for the millennials, millennial generation, because towards the end of the month, a lot of people, we understand what happens. So this gives them all the services. You pay at the end of the month, and we don't have any risk because we have that 2 months security deposit. So any which way, we are covered. So this provides them a handy solution. So this is a one-stop solution which we have. Why now? Lack of space in center of the cities, which is the biggest problem that we are facing right now, because our cities are expanding outside. Now if I have to live, earlier I was renting out a 2 BHK, now probably I'll have 3 friends and I'll rent out a 2 BHK. So that trend has picked up really well, and there's a huge displacement in population, and people now want a one-stop shop. So I don't want to have any tension, I don't want to interact with anyone. You just give me everything, I'll give you a bit extra, but you give me everything. So that trend has picked up really well. This is about the sector. Now coming about the co-living as a domain, when you talk, it started from paying guests to hostels to service apartments to co-living, and now people are talking about community living. Right? So when you talk about community living, it's still in very, very nascent stage, and a lot of education is needed in this space. But it's about helping each other grow. It's like creating a community of living places, people living in a distributed network of houses and still connected together through a platform. So our total addressable market is around 2.5 crores. That's the tier 1 city rental population across all top 6 cities. then around 50 lakh is what comes in our which can be addressed by us, but we are readily okay to address at least 1 lakh of them at this point of time. This is a list of our competitors, each unique in its own ways, but here I have listed the competitive advantages of what SimplyCash does. So every one of them has a different model. Like one is a platform, other one is a platform plus some service. So a lot of them have a lot of services, but what we as SimplyCash and as an ecosystem provider, it's a distributed service model. The supply gets unlimited when you have a distributed service model. When you go on a building model and want to take up buildings, you can only tie up of buildings and have this much growth. You cannot grow beyond that because houses are there, they are already built. You cannot raise them and build a new one. So servicing the existing supply is important, and that's the main differentiator of what we are doing and creating a cluster system where housekeeping, maintenance, repairs, bill payments, everything is done and managed by us. And it becomes easy operationally because we have built a cluster where we have around 40 houses in and around Banerghatta Road and Kormangla, and it's a 20-minute ride from any point to any point. And that all is managed by the technology. So it's like an on-road price with us rather than an ex-showroom price. So that's a classic definition of how I can put SimplyCash. Since last 3 years of our operations, we have built a lot of I'll need a minute more. So we have built a lot of technology around the key nuances and the problems that we are trying to solve. Those are listed here, and these are related to housekeeping management. Key management is a huge thing, and these are small problems. So we have 3-member team, and we have solved all of that for and scaled up from 0 to 2 crores in yearly revenue because of the technology that we have built over a period of 2.5 years. So business model is service fee recurring. The rent ranges from 9,000 to 25,000. Our current customer acquisition model is 20% through referrals and around 5% through content marketing, which we do invest on a regular basis, and then on Google and Facebook ads, which it comes through. This is a team. We are a 3-member team. Subbu is, he used to work with APG. He has 18 years of experience in tech. And Amrisha used to work with Karnataka government. So he is our whole and sole operations guy. And I take care of the marketing and media outreach. These are our financials. You can just have a look. Two numbers that I want to shout out is the revenue per month per customer and the average tenancy duration. So the revenue per month per customer comes to around 12.3k, and average tenancy duration is 7 days. Our first customer, who when we started, is still with us right now, and she has been living for 34 months with SimplyCash. So this is our future plan of what we need. So our 80% of the capital that we need will go towards acquiring new supply and furnishing, like getting into agreements with them, because this is an operations heavy model, and it will continue to be operations heavy. So it requires capital to grow, and our only need of capital is for growth, because otherwise we are sustainable in terms of surviving, but now growth is needed, and that's why capital is needed, and that's the future plan that we have. So thanks a lot. We have written a detailed investor guide. You can look at it at invest.simplycash.com. That's our way of making people educating people about this space. So yeah, that's it. We have been covered by various medias, and this is our way of educating customers. We use a lot of comics, which is done by Ponappa and Ramya, and we communicate it because it's a nascent space, and we believe a customer education will play an important part in long term. So yeah, that's it.
So you have to be careful about this especially.
Definitely.
This week. Because especially into this week, because I know few of the competitors.
Yeah,
so you have to be very careful that you always to go, not to go, here or there.
It's a fine balance that you have to maintain between your working capital and your the operations in our organized sector. So we have seen a lot of my 80% customers at this point of time are from Omegle and SAP. So we have seen a lot of those transitions happening, and a lot of them keep happening. But I agree with you that working capital will always be a challenge with us, and that is something which we will have to balance and run. And the way we do it right now is we grow every alternate, we expand every alternate month, so that we balance. We take 1 month to settle down, and the next month we expand. Then we take 1 month to settle down. That's because we are bootstrapped, we don't have that access to that much capital. So that's our way of managing working capital as well as expansion.
So basically, this guarantees the owner an income, irrespective of. So you cover that, right? It's a fund-based business.
There are both the models. So if a owner wants to go for fixed rental, that is possible. But then the monthly rentals will reduce a bit. And if they want to go with a variable model based on occupancy and they are okay with going around that, they'll get a higher rental income. So they have that option and they can choose from.
So where is the fee? Where do you get the fee? Because I saw the slide some 1.4.
Yes.
Where is the fee? What is the fee
tenant,
that you get?
Tenant, our margins are around 25 to 30% from the tenant rent that they give. The
so
rent.
You collect the rent and give to the
owners. Yeah. So we are. So we pass through the rent that we have agreed on, either on a fixed rental model or a variable rental model, and then we keep the service fee. And a lot of upselling happens through our ecosystem of services.
So this largely seems to be catering to shared, where shared homes, right? It's not for families or something.
Families we have not catered yet, but
so share.
Couples are there. No, we cater to couples. So we have a lot of studio rooms and 1 BHKs where couples take our services. So
you don't have to deal with societies basically.
No, we do. We do. So we have a lot of four or five of our houses are in societies. And societies, so there is no law which prevents owners to renting it out through us. But societies do come into play and they try to stop you from doing it. We have a very strong backing of on off law where it states that we are a services company and the owner, agreement happens between the owner and the tenant. So we are here a service provider and it's not a commercially run thing. It's just we are just an enabler for both the parties.
Are the couples staying
married
or do you care?
We don't care. We don't get into moral policing. We don't get into moral policing. It's because these are working professionals, we get all the documents and everything, and it's, agreement it's very clearly written. So we are saying they don't actually.
Even society. There's one side on which you have a basket of services that you propose to actually. The early one. It's almost 6 or 7.
No, yeah, actually, are servicing currently. Those are not proposed.
They are actually.
We are doing that sales. Already.
But you only have vendors who do all this, right?
No.
Hyperlocal.
The power of having one bill at the end of the month and a credit which comes with it make people use these services. So I can go and rent it from Rent on Go or some other thing or furniture from somewhere. But I have to manage that again. I have to go and talk to them and get the bicycle and everything.
I think
so that makes people use it.